crazy.
Gerçek çiçek vardı. Mesela gerçek bir menekşe vardı. Bir de plastik menekşe vardı. Satılır. Plastikten yapılmış. Şimdi sahteleri ne insanlar kullanıyorlar? Bayağı bir yerde. Yani o menekşe...
There is a real flower. For example, there is a violet and a real violet.
Tarzında,
and there is plastic violet that is salt, one made of plastic. People in most places are using the artificial one these days.
Arabası için, evi için ve tip için diyor.
They are trying to do things resembling love in the manner of a stage actor. But the person he is speaking about immediately sees through this. When he asks why he is loved, the answer is for his car, for his home, or for his looks. So there is clearly nothing resembling true love at all in that. Obviously, if anything happens to his good looks, the other person will disappear. So what is the point of games? But that is how they deceive some poor people, and the other party believes it. That poor person is deceived and thinks he is loved for his own sake, and one day he hopes he will discover himself. And that cunning person realizes that and approaches the other person from his or her blind side, saying that this is very meaningful and the first time they have discovered love. The other person literally becomes hypnotized, and they then do whatever the other person says. Some women are cunning like that. They wrap themselves around one and sometimes make use of the family too, acting in an organized manner. That poor person literally becomes their yes, prisoner. One also sees that with men. A young girl is rich, but physically unattractive. One often sees that. There was a case just recently of some famous person with a daughter who is very unattractive. That is how Allah created her. And she was not that striking in terms of culture and personality. All she had was her money. And this person spoke to the press in an unbelievable language, saying he had tested love for the first time with her. Everyone was laughing up their sleeve. It was so obviously a lie. But he had obviously planned to pull the wool over her eyes and eventually lay hands on all her money. That is truly horrible and disgraceful behavior, unbefitting a human being. But if that girl has good taqwa and good moral virtues, even though she is physically unremarkable, Allah will make her seem beautiful to that other person. Because a great majesty will arise, in other words, an amazing power will emerge, and what is unremarkable will be transformed into great beauty. Because intelligence makes people beautiful. Passion makes people beautiful. That deep power in the soul comes to the surface, and then the other things are just flesh. Like when they slaughter a cow at the butcher's and hang it on hooks, it is just flesh. There is no difference. People can deepen themselves with love, taqwa and love of Allah. And thus they can bring out that great power that Allah conceals within them. And this comes out as a miracle. I call it a kind of sixth sense. This is not something that someone who hasn't experienced it can understand. People must be genuine in their love for one another and must look for true intellect and for the real person.
Eğer mümin Allah rızasını taşımıyorsa, Allah'ın rızasına yaklaşmıyorsa, kalbinde sevgi olmaz. Mesela evlenecek insanlar oluyor.
If a believer doesn't have Allah's approval, if he doesn't approach people with Allah's approval, then there can be no love in his heart. People are going to get married, for instance. The girl says she has met someone truly wonderful, that she has fallen in love for the first time in her life, that she has never known anyone like him. It is as if she's been hypnotized. She says she has met the man of her dreams. And the other person naively believes her out of a joy of being loved or else as a result of pride. In other words, he doesn't look for the cause. He doesn't wonder why that person loves. He doesn't stop to wonder whether she would have loved me if I didn't have a car Or if I didn't earn so much money.
Birisiyle karşılaşmış olmanın heyecanıyla.
He believes her out of the excitement that comes from meeting someone whom he imagines has discovered his true worth. He is amazed that he has been discovered. He is led astray by thinking he has been discovered for the first time. However, the woman actually harbors a subconscious hatred of him because of his stupidity, because of his failure to see the truth. Because she sees him as prey, like prey that has fallen into her web, like a tiny fly, and he wriggles just like a fly. And she slowly winds him in, telling that poor man what an impact he has had on her, how wonderful he is, and how there is no one else like him. And he naively believes her, but this is mutual torment. She deceives herself, despite knowing in her heart of hearts that it is his wealth that has had such an impact on her, and that it is his wealth she is after, and that she will eventually hate him, and that subconscious hatred duly appears. The woman will automatically be disgusted by him, but her self-interest override it, because she will have money and cars and fine clothes, and those are more attractive to her. The pleasure those give her suppresses her disgust and allows her to put up with him. And she tries not to let on any of this while she is putting up with him, of course. She finds various ways of avoiding doing so. There are ways of appearing to be nice to one another. She makes him a nice dinner and says she has been waiting for him while he says he has found her a lovely ring. Then they embrace one another and he whirls her around, like in the films. How pitiful it is for people to spend all their lives living a lie, pretending.
It's the worst suffering for a woman to live in the pretense she loves someone when she doesn't, just for gain. For a man to know that he is not loved, to fool himself that he is loved even though he doesn't really believe it. For them to pretend to love one another as if they were the greatest actor and actress in the world. It's one of the worst scourges inflicted by Allah. But in true love, people seek neither possessions, nor money, nor anything else. If they see a manifestation of Allah in the other person, they're hypnotized by that man or woman. Allah bestows such a power. For example, Pharaoh's woman was tremendously affected by the Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, left Pharaoh's side, married the Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and lived with him in the desert for 40 years. The Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, had no possessions. All he offered her was suffering and trouble. But she saw a manifestation of Allah in the Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, for which reason she felt a profound love for him. That's what is known as passion. For example, a woman who was married our Prophet's slave, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, was divorced and married our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She saw in him the radiance, beauty and manifestation of Allah, and much more besides. In other words, she saw a much greater manifestation in him than in her own husband. Allah states in his verses that the Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, were embarrassed and hid this in his heart, but that Allah knew it all the time. And Allah's command has now been performed, he states. Allah arranged for the woman to divorce his slave and to marry the Prophet with the verses of the Quran. But the Prophet declined. He told his wife, do not divorce, carry on as you are. He meant that their marriage should continue. But it all came about with Allah's revelation, and his command was obeyed. That was passion. In other words, the woman did this as a requirement of the passion she felt toward the manifestation of Allah. We see many examples of this in history. It also happened with other prophets. Loving for Allah's approval is something totally different. It is a most profound pleasure. There's a special force in people for this. A feeling rather like a sixth sense. In other words, it resembles neither sight, nor hearing, nor touch. It's a profound, intense, and ineffable sensation. It's a profound force. We call it passion. People imitate passion and love. I see it on the television, for instance. They say they are in love. I wonder what they are in love with.
Will that love survive in the absence of a good job or money? They say that in that case they will get divorced. So it has nothing to do with love at all.
Kadıncağız mesela yaşlanıyor, doğuruyor, deforme oluyor.
A woman grows old, for instance, gives birth and loses her figure. It is immoral to then send her back to her parents. Of course, she has given birth and undergone that pain for Allah's approval. In other words, she has trusted in him. She knew her body would be spoiled. She made a sacrifice. So it would be very wrong to treat her like that. One's love for such a woman will actually increase. One will have even more affection, compassion and love for her, because she has assumed that form alongside one. She has ended up like that for Allah's sake. It's therefore no reason to go off her. But such things are quite possible among people with a facile perspective.